What's up, game developers? CouchFerret here, and today we'll draw walls, grass, and flowers to have a few sprites to design our first level. We'll figure out how big a unit is in our world, and also we'll try out different perspectives to find out which one fits in our game the best. If it sounds fun, then stay with me and consider subscribing with the bell icon so you won't miss any future videos of this game. Cool, let's begin! Let's open up Aseprite and create a new sprite with the size 300 by 300. I've selected a few grays for our walls, copied the archer to have a size reference, and set the background to a greenish color. I'm planning to use grids in Unity to align the sprites in the level. Because of that, we need to figure out the size of a unit in our world in pixels. Let's turn on the grid in Aseprite with its default 16 by 16 resolution, and use the archer as a guide. This is too big. Our archer's width is 9 pixels, so let's round it up to 10 and set the grid's resolution to 10 by 10. Now he fits the grid pretty well. Instead of jumping right into drawing the walls, it would be wise to figure out the correct perspective so the walls won't look strange in our game. Drawing a few boxes, we can see which one looks good next to the archer. Let's have a 10x10 rectangle as the front face of the box and a 10x7 for the top face. I'll quickly shade it so it doesn't look flat. To make the rest of the perspectives, let's copy them by making each of its top faces smaller by 1 pixel every time. This way, we are slightly changing each box's perspective. Let's turn off the grid to see which one feels right with our archer. I think this one will be the winner. It has a 10x4 pixel top face, which means that in our perspective, one unit is horizontally 10 pixels, but it's vertically just 4. We need to adjust the grid to this new perspective as well. Now we can delete the rest of the boxes, because we won't need them. Let's scale down the box a bit, so it fits the grid. We can use this small box as a guide to building our wall in the same perspective. Let's make the wall a bit taller and wider by stacking a few of these boxes on top of each other. Then we need to merge the boxes together so it creates one big wall. Let's draw a stone block pattern on it with a darker shade and smooth out the edges so it makes the wall horizontally tileable. Aseprite has a cool feature for tilemaps which repeats the same tile so you can preview how it will look if you put copies next to each other. Let's select the whole wall, copy it, and go to File, New. Copying the wall automatically fills the dimension of the new sprite. We need to paste it and go to View, Tiled Mode, so we can turn on horizontal tiling by hitting Tiled in X-axis. Aseprite puts duplicates next to the sprite and updates them while we are drawing. It's pretty helpful. Let's copy the shades to a new layer for a second, so we don't lose the highlight grays. If we draw a few pixels with them, then we can simply color pick the shades later, so we don't need this shades layer. Okay, we have to fix the stone blocks, because they look a bit messed up. Now they seem even, so let's fix the second row too. Cool, we can start shading the wall. Let's use the dark shades and the highlights to make the stones rougher, so they don't look like perfectly cut stone blocks. If we hit View, Preview, then a preview window pops up where we can see our wall from a distance. It looks pretty good, maybe we should add more highlights. I think we are done. Let's hit Command A or Control A on Windows to select the whole sprite and copy it back into our original sprite. To make our walls a bit more fun, let's create pillars for its ends. We can stack 3 of those boxes to get a good base for our tall pillar. Let's shade it like the wall, and we don't need rounded edges. As a final touch, let's break up those corners of the stones a bit with a lighter shade. If we turn back on the grid, we can see that the pillar fits perfectly. I'm thinking about moving the wall 1 pixel up, so it looks a bit thinner than the pillar. And we also need to scale it back by 1 pixel, so it fits the grid again. Let's turn off the grid and see how it looks so far. Awesome! Let's try this out by building a complete wall. Cool, this is how it will look in our game. To be able to build a fun level for our archer in the next episode, we need to draw a vertical wall as well. Let's copy the top face of the wall and rotate it 90 degrees. We need to turn back on the grid so we can scale down the wall vertically to match the perspective. Let's try it out by continuing the wall upwards. We have to duplicate one of the pillars and fill the gap between them with vertical wall pieces. Okay, let's turn off the grid so we can take a better look. It's not bad, but maybe a bit thin. Let's select and move both sides of the wall by 1 pixel to make the wall thicker. That's better. It still feels a bit flat and boring, so beat up the stones slightly. Cool. To make our art pop, let's create some shadows for it. We can pick a gray from the wall and let's add a new layer, call it shadows, and set its opacity to 99. Now we can draw a line of semi-transparent pixels below our wall. I think we are done with the wall. It looks quite good. Before we end this episode, let's quickly draw grass and flowers. It will make our levels way juicier. A few pixels of bright green perfectly represents grass. I love how simple pixel art is. Let's pick a light yellow and draw 2 rectangles near each other. These will be flowers. If we give them shadows, then it will make them pop. And finally, let's make a common flower shape as well with a light blue color, and don't forget to give it shadows. Okay, as the final step, we need to organize all of our art to a new sprite sheet, so we can use them in Unity next time. Let's create a new 128 by 128 sprite. It will be easier to copy the art if we merge the layers together. Let's copy them one by one and place them nicely in the new sprite. I've messed up the flower's shadow, so I'm fixing it quickly. And finally, let's export this new sprite as a PNG. I think they look awesome. Can't wait to use them in Unity. That's it for today, folks. Next time, we will design our first level in Unity with grids and prefabs. We will also start working on collisions, so our archer won't be able to run through walls. So be sure to subscribe and leave a thumbs up. If you have any questions about what you have just seen, feel free to ask and I try to answer all of them. See you next time!